This is a review of the Mola Tambaqui standalone DAC. Now, lots of history went into this DAC. The design team, the original design team, consisted of Bruno Putzis. They brought in together an expert team in digital design. This is a ground-up design. The digital algorithms were all done in-house. Now, it started off in the line stage, in the Makua line stage. Right in the middle of the line stage, there's a space for double stack boards. That's what the DAC was designed in, and now it has its own standalone box. So you don't have to have a Mola line stage to use its exceptional digital qualities. This DAC has garnered so many awards over the years, it is in a league of its own. It's beautiful to behold. Look at it. It's only 5.1 kilograms. It's made for state-of-the-art minimal music system. Tambaqui shares the same chassis as the Kaluga amplifiers, the monoblocks. The only difference is the Tambaqui, it has that circle that shows you what display you're on, whether you're on balanced or network, or in our case, we tested this with the Spitif. We're spinning CDs off of the Audio Note Level 6 transport. It's a tube-based transport. Anyway, back to the converter. The heart of the converter is the sandwich stack. So the first board, the digital signal coming in, is instantly upsampled to 3.125 megahertz at 32-bit. From there, it's converted to PWM. Then on the second stage are the DACs. So they're mono DACs. There's a discrete 32-stage FIR DAC and a single stage fourth order filtering IV converter. Together, they turn PWM into analog at an astonishing 130 decibel signal to noise ratio. There's nothing like it. Let's take a look at the back of the unit. There's a 6.3 millimeter headphone jack. There's also, and this is really cool, there's a XLR headphone jack as well. So it can power up even the tricky to drive headphones. It has analog outputs, stereo pair, XLR, and RCA
adapters.
It has trigger outputs. This is for Mola configurations to shut on and off Mola power amplifiers. It has mains power input. Now the digital inputs, HDMI with I2S, network input, Spitif input, balanced input, and they have an optical Toslink input. The USB input is a type B. For DSD, streaming into the DAC, you're going to have to use the USB or the network inputs, digital inputs. I've heard Mola many times at GTT Audio and at the numerous hi-fi shows where Mola exhibits. It is always a highly sophisticated, detailed sound that's easy on the ears. It has an organic quality, but yet it's got an astonishing amount of detail. All of their components, it's just so realistic. The amplifiers are switching amplifiers. We shot a video up at GTT a couple months ago on the amplifiers. I couldn't believe that they're switching amplifiers. This DAC, I can't believe it's, I think I'm listening to the record player. It is that analog-like. Okay, before we do the listening session, I've invited Bill Parrish in to talk about the connectability of the DAC. We'll talk about Roon, what a Roon endpoint is, how you stream with the DAC, since we were just using CD here. So let's welcome Bill in on a video.
Well, viewers, welcome Bill Parrish to AV Showrooms.
Thank you, Peter. It's good to be down here.
Good to have you down, Bill. This DAC is exceptional. Now, you guys are going to listen in the upcoming listening session to a track we just played. We played The Wind That Shakes the Barley and by a Dead Can Dance, Lisa Gerrard singing.
Oh, man.
Bill.
I was blown away.
I saw Bill.
This DAC on this system, there's purity that's just unparalleled.
It's astonishingly pure. Astonishing. I mean, you could hear in Lisa Gerrard's voice that almost where there was like almost an end point to the human voice and then the beginning of the reverb.
Yeah.
And then the whole reverb filter. I never heard it delineated like that. Ever.
No, it
ever.
Captures it.
Ever.
It captures it.
Ever.
All. Yeah.
Ever.
Yeah, it's ever. Absolutely phenomenal. You know, this is the first time I think I had mentioned to you that I'm hearing it out of a transport. I mean, most of us don't do that anymore. And I know, you know, at the beginning, you were a little nervous about taking on the Tambaqui because of all the features that it offers, and I told you, forget about all the features. Use it as a conventional DAC.
Yeah,
and, you know, that's the whole thing. It's while it has all these features and it has Roon endpoints and every and Bluetooth right from the phone is one of the endpoints.
Yeah, I didn't cover that.
And
yeah,
you can do all the different presets, and there's an app and. Guys that are using transports and CDs aren't used to all these features, and you got a little like, oh, I don't, you know. No, it can be used as a conventional DAC or the absolute latest technology, if you will. But regardless of what you put into it, it separates it into 32-bit, 3.125 kilohertz.
Yep.
I mean, it just upsamples everything, runs it. It's amazing.
Yeah.
Now, I don't think you covered this, and if you did, excuse me, but something I want to cover
What's
is,
that, Bill?
You know, people in the back, they take a look at this on the internet or whatever, and they go, oh, it doesn't have RCA outputs.
Yeah.
I can't use it. It only has balance outputs. Well, every one of these DACs ships with these adapters.
There you go.
And now you have your RCA.
Now you have your RCA,
And I challenge anyone to say there's sonic degradation here. Mm-hmm. There's not. Mm-hmm. I mean, we're using it. Mm-hmm. What's the retail of this system?
Well, it's interesting.
I mean, do you have a $150,000 transport on this?
It's a $150,000 transport. Well, it's $22,000 amplifier and $15,000 speakers. It is a little unbalanced in its price point because the transports match to the audio note system.
Probably $300,000 in cables.
The cables cost more than the DAC. Your DAC.
Well, that's for
and
sure.
And that system.
But you know, I'm using it in a close to $1 million system. We have clients that are using in that system and $700,000-$800,000 systems. This thing holds its own. And most of the people are using single-ended output. So, you know, BATs ship their products like that for years. Mm-hmm. So don't be intimidated by that. And don't think that Mola's giving you cheap ones either. They are selected for Sonics.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Well, thanks for a little bit more information on the DAC. What we're going to do is bring you to the listening session part of our review. And I want to thank Bill Parrish for coming down.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, thank you for having me down here and being part of this.
Yeah,
it's much appreciated.
Yeah, it's nice to put a face and a voice together and to see Bill does is the U.S. distributor for Mola Mola.
Canada, too.
And
Canada, too. Yeah.
Okay.
All in North America.
Awesome. I'm super impressed. Wait till you see what I have to say about it.
Thanks, Bill. You're a true audio expert. So now we know the connectivity of the Tambaqui. Well, on to my favorite part of the review, the listening session. We're featuring a track by Dead Can Dance. It's Lisa Gerrard. She's singing The Wind That Shakes the Barley. It's beautiful. It's got all that reverb in there. Wait till you hear it. And we're going to feature Ain't No Sunshine When She's Gone by Buddy Guy and Tracy Chapman. So, here we go.
I sat within the barley green, I sat me with my true love. My sad heart strove the two between, the old love and the new love. The old for her, the new that made me think on island dearly. While soft the wind blew down the glade and shook the golden barley. T'was hard the woeful words to frame, to break the ties that bound us, and harder still to bear the shame of foreign chains around us. And so I said, the mountain glen I'll meet at morning early, and I'll join the bold united men while soft winds shook the barley. 'Twas said I kissed away her tears, my fond arm round her flinging, when a form and shuffler stung our ears from out the wild woods ringing. A bullet pierced my true love's side in life's young spring so early, and on my breast in blood she died while soft winds shook the barley. But blood for blood, without remorse, I've tamer to ter tallow. I've lain my true love's clay-like corpse, where I'll fall soon must follow. Around her grave I've wandered drear, in night and morning early, with breaking heart when near I hear the wind that shakes the barley.
Sunshine when she's gone, it's not warm when she's away. Ain't no sunshine when she's gone, she's always gone too long. Anytime she goes away, thank you. sunshine when she's gone. Ain't no sunshine when she's gone. Only darkness every day. Ain't no sunshine when she's gone. This house just ain't home. Anytime she goes away.
Simply fantastic, both of those tracks. I love to use The Dead Can Dance so you can get a feel for the transient response of the system. It is such a simple recording, simply mic'd recording. Lisa Gerard's voice is beautifully mic'd. It fills the whole room, The Wind That Shakes the Barley. One of my favorite tracks that we use, that we've been using for up to 10 years now on AV Showrooms videos. So there's a consistency. So you can judge the different systems. What I hear on this system with the Tambaqui DAC is I hear an enormous sound field. It's just stunningly enormous. Within the sound stage and the field, the instruments are presented in a very holographic way. You would not know you were listening to digital. And I said this in a video a couple of videos ago, blindfolded. Listening to the Mola Mola up at GTT Audio, I wouldn't have known, I could have sworn it could have been a massive tube amplifier. It was so holographic. Same thing with the Tambaqui DAC. It's got the tail retrieval that is equal to any digital I've heard, but yet it doesn't have any digital artifact. There is no harsh digital edge. It is just simply the instruments and the musicians are simply there, right in your room. The associated equipment for today's review includes the Cube Audio Nanufar 10 speakers, the Audio Note CDT6 tube-driven transport. Very unique. The amplifier is the Aries Surratt Janus. It's a 22-watt per channel, single-ended triode amplifier. It's stunningly atmospheric. And we have Steel Point apertures for room treatment. Stands are by Modulum Platforms from Canada. Cabling by Synergistic Research and Zeus DTC. Audio Note and Purist Audio Design. Of course, we're not in the review today, but next to me is the one of the best analog front ends in the world, the Kronos Pro. And that completes the system. I love it also because it's such a beautiful to behold unit. But this would be a desert island system. It's just beautiful. A simple apartment in Manhattan, gorgeous apartment up in Montreal, apartment in Hong Kong. This is made for that. Made for that. Your summer home at the shore, your cabin in the mountains, made for it. And again, it's simple to behold. I mean, it's two basic design boxes for the whole lineup of the Mola Mola product line. It's simple, beautiful, it's expensive. It's got a high quality of ownership. It's Mola Mola. So overall, the Tambaqui DAC, one of the finest DACs available on the marketplace today. If you're in the market for a super sexy system that's simple, it's beautiful, reach out to Mola Mola, GTT Audio. GTT Audio is the U.S. distributor for Mola Mola. Contact Bill Parrish, and he can talk you through the different products how they work, and how they interface with each other. So, Peter Bruninger reporting on the Mola Mola Tambaqui DAC here at AV Showrooms. Thanks for watching. Bye.